And now we continue our look at the candidates who are seeking their party's nominations in the race to replace Mike Michaud in Maine's 2nd Congressional District. WMTW News 8's political reporter Paul Merrill joins us now live to profile Troy Jackson. Paul?
Steve, whether it's speaking out against logging industry leaders or going toe-to-toe with Governor LePage, Democrat Troy Jackson portrays himself as a fierce defender of the rights of working-class Mainers.
You know, in this race, when I looked around at who else had declared that they were going to run, I didn't feel that anyone was actually supporting working class ideals.
Troy Jackson sees himself as an outsider in the race for Congress. Sitting in the Lewiston Public Library, the 45-year-old logger from Allegash talked about being shunned by members of his own party.
I don't speak well. I'm not in their social economic scale. You know, I don't go to all the parties and all that that these people do, and I think they see me as someone that, you know, was a little bit radical and maybe challenges their way of life.
I'm Troy Jackson. I'm running for Congress in Metro 2.
Jackson says his opponents within the Democratic Party have responded to that challenge by dumping money into the campaign of his primary opponent, Emily Kane.
Yep. Just because you're rich, you don't get to decide who gets elected in this country.
Hi, how you doing?
Jackson says he is the only candidate in this race who sticks to his principles at the negotiating table.
I think that's truly is a difference between myself and Senator Kane and the two Republicans, is that, you know, they want to go in the room and come out and say, look what we did. But when they go in the room, it usually means working class people are going to lose something.
Kane has called Jackson out for his 2009 vote against marriage equality. He's since changed his position.
It was the worst vote that I've ever taken. I feel very bad about it. I have since then personally supported that in the referendum, said it publicly.
I think the governor realizes that.
Other things Jackson has said publicly include attack after attack on Governor LePage's leadership.
That's not the way that you do things if you're going to be an elected official.
The two have publicly feuded.
People like Troy Jackson, they ought to go back in the woods and cut trees.
Jackson says that back and forth shows that he's not willing to bend to pressure.
I'm not at all afraid to do that. I mean, you talk about, you know, my stance against Governor LePage, well, you know, John Boehner's not going to scare me either. So
Jackson hopes he will be part of a freshman class in Congress made up of other people who are fed up with Washington and looking to change it.
It was great to meet you both.
I got to believe that's going to happen, because I think we're all in trouble if it isn't.
Tomorrow we begin profiling the Republican candidates in this primary, Bruce Poliquin tomorrow and Kevin Ray on Friday. Live in the studio, Paul Merrill, WMTW News 8.